On January 7th this year, I officially gave up on getting one of the two pre-built DDR controllers to work and started on working on my own implementation of a DDR controller. It has been over 2.5 months, but what you're seeing now on screen is it. A working DDR controller built from scratch by myself. It's even smaller than either of the existing implementations. Allow me to explain what you're actually seeing. I'm using a generator to create a sequence of pseudo-random numbers. For each such number, I write it to memory and immediately read it back. If the readback is not the same, I print a warning message. I use this algorithm to write to the whole memory. When finished, I read the data back in and compare to what the generator says should be in that place. If there's a mismatch, I print a warning. Writing and then reading 64 megabytes of memory takes about 20 seconds. When the whole sequence is done, I print the number of iterations performed, the number of new errors detected this time, as well as the total number of errors across all iterations. I then start a new iteration. Between each two iterations, I change the starting point of the sequence. This means that no memory cell receives the same value between two consecutive iterations. The number of iterations is printed in hexadecimal, so what you're seeing here is the system running for 13,439 iterations, a little over 3 days. The total number of errors is zero. My DDR controller works. In the previous video, I said the FPGA may not be fast enough to even allow that to work. Responding to a comment by John, I realized the scope of what I meant may not have been correctly understood, so let's clarify. The DDR controller you see actually running is not with the upgraded FPGA, it is with the original one. While the design does not report any errors, that's mainly because I haven't defined the proper constraints. In other words, it doesn't know how fast it needs to work, so it doesn't know it's not fast enough. With that said, these reports are under certain worst-case scenarios. Even after running for over 3 days non-stop, the FPGA is hardly warmer than room temperature. Since the FPGA is rated to work at up to 85 degrees Celsius, or 185 Fahrenheit, it means we can expect much better performance from it in practice than the rated worst case, which is what the timing analysis is checking. The new FPGA's package carry a warning saying they must be installed within a certain amount of time from opening the package. As such, I'm holding off on installing them until I absolutely need to. For now, I'm moving forward with the slower FPGAs. Well, I can honestly say that I've learned a lot during these 2.5 months. I'm very glad that this task is finally over. I would like to extend my endless gratitude to my loyal Patreon supporters for sticking with me through this challenging times. You are awesome. So until next time, thank you for watching.